a Swedish style of accessible pedestrian signals can now be found in lots of different places around the world. Here's one in Sweden, and I want to highlight some really cool things about this. There is a tactile map on the control box.
An arrow points up to a vertical line going across the map, and that tells you the route you want to take. Cars are represented by rectangles, raised rectangles. There are two on the left side, two on the right side. That tells you it's a four-lane street. And in the middle of the street is an oval. That means there's an island.
So when I approach this intersection, I'm getting lots of valuable information about what to expect, how long it's going to take me to get across. If I reach an island, I actually know it's an island and not the other side of the street. So this is powerful. I have three more things to highlight here. On the top, there's an arrow. Sometimes intersections are angled. So the arrow is angled slightly to let you know how you should cross the street. When you tap the top of the control box, you can increase the volume of the audio signal. And on the bottom, there's a star, a tactile star, and it vibrates to tell you when it's time to cross. Isn't that cool? It's a lot of information, and it gives the pedestrian choices about, do they want audio? Do they want tactile signals? Do they want it louder, quieter? And if you don't want any of this info, you don't have to use the control box. You can ignore it. So I'm going to hit the button.
My guide dog and I reached the other side of the street.